This is Odyssey. Today we'll be starting a new series talking about the Epic of Gilgamesh, who's a character that spanned across the entire Final Fantasy series as a reoccurring enemy. This series is going to be broken down into three small parts. We're going to begin by looking at the overall character design, as in what makes Gilgamesh Gilgamesh, by using that knowledge that we get from analyzing Gilgamesh to design our own, a redesign of Gilgamesh to fit in Final Fantasy games that he wasn't originally part in, such as Final Fantasy X. Now let's get started talking about the origin of Gilgamesh. Gilgamesh originates from Sumerian mythology as a half-human, half-god type of character, and represents the pinnacle of human civilization. We can also infer from the references that Gilgamesh was also inspired by the Genji era of Japan, but we'll get into the design later. The last reference for Gilgamesh in the real world is the story of the armed samurai Benkei. This can be inferred by the fact that every time you encounter Gilgamesh in Final Fantasy, you battle him on the bridge, which is the key trait in the Benkei story. A little bit about Benkei is that he was a warrior monk who lived during the Heian period of Japan. His warrior monk lifestyle is reflected in his in-game design because his weapon is the weapon of the monk, the Ninjanata, or the spear. World building wise, think of this as an amazing way to create unique characters by combining different mythologies from different parts of the world into its own unique thing. Now let's get into the tale of Gilgamesh in Final Fantasy. Gilgamesh is introduced as a sort of comedic relief type of character. His design is intimidating, but yet his personality is a complete contrast to his serious and threatening design. However, in latter games, he becomes much more serious, such as Gilgamesh in Final Fantasy XV, who is cutthroat in his approach to battle. In order to see why Gilgamesh's design is really intimidating, we first have to take a look at, you know what, his silhouette. Now overall, Gilgamesh is a very complex silhouette. Don't be intimidated by that though. If you really squint and take a good look, his silhouette main shape is a triangle. Shape language that means he's supposed to be some type of enemy of a sort. And so as the iterations of Gilgamesh change, so does his silhouette and design. They begin to use different overlapping shapes to give more meaning to his character. Now the next big thing to focus on when we're talking about Gilgamesh is his detail. And by narrowing down the key details that he has in each game, we can figure out what makes Gilgamesh consistent throughout each of the Final Fantasy games. Now, the most consistent details that Gilgamesh has is his horns, his shin guards, and his Genji armor. But occasionally he can be found with a spike shoulder guard. Consistency is crucial when designing a character that goes across a wide range of games, but his personality doesn't change. Now, no matter what game that you go to, we can find what makes Gilgamesh consistent. His red color scheme, his complex silhouette, and the fact that he always carries several weapons, and oftentimes several limbs. That concludes our introduction into the tale of Gilgamesh. During our next episode, we'll be actually taking a look at the steps to design a Gilgamesh for different Final Fantasy worlds that he didn't appear in. Like, comment, and subscribe, and stay tuned because we got a lot more coming.